Hey everyone, welcome to Talent Battle. In this video, I'm going to solve questions which we asked during our mock test. We got really huge response for our mock test from all over India. In this particular video, I'm going to solve questions based on quantitative aptitude section. We have created two parts for the second test. You can check the first part. I'll be adding link of that first part in the description box. Before starting with the video, if you have not subscribed to our channel yet, just make sure you are subscribing so that you don't miss on any important campus update, as well as make sure you are joining our Telegram group and WhatsApp group to make sure you are receiving updates very quickly. So now let's start with the questions. Now let's check this particular question. A dealer paid a car manufacturer ₹1,35,000 for a car. What should be the selling price of car if after allowing a buyer 10% discount on the selling price, he made a profit of 8% on his outlay? So now what they are exactly saying, a dealer paid car manufacturer ₹1,35,000 for a car. So that means they have provided you cost price of that car, which is ₹1,35,000. So I will just write it down over here. Next thing, what should be the selling price if on selling price, a dealer provides a 10% discount, and after providing a 10% discount also, still he makes a profit of 8%. So one thing we need to understand, we need to check what is the final selling price which gives 8% of profit. Now what is the formula of selling price and cost price? We know selling price is equal to cost price into 100 plus profit percentage divided by 100. So over here we know cost price, which is 1,35,000, and 8% profit on the end. So we can say 100 plus 8, which is 108 divided by 100. So 0 and 0 will get cancelled. If you calculate this 1350 into 108, that value is going to be 145800. So final selling price at which a manufacturer or a dealer is going to sell is 1,45,800. Now, but we want to find out initial selling price, or you can say mark price, which was there on that car. So after providing 10% discount on that, he is going to sell it at this particular price. So let me consider that initial selling price as X. If that person is providing 10% discount, means I can write it like 90/100. Whenever we are providing 10% discount on anything, it means we are selling it at 90% of the value. So I will just multiply that initial selling price into 90/100. And after providing 10% discount, I am selling it at 1,45,800. So now just you need to do this particular calculation. 10 into 9, 10 into 10. So X is going to be 1,45,800 into 10 by 9. Now, if you want to calculate further, 9 into 1, 9 into 1 will be over here. 55 means 9 into 6, 18 means 2. So this is going to be 16,200 into 10 means 1,62,000. So you can check, this is going to be the final price. Okay, so initial selling price was 1,62,000, and after providing 10% discount, he sells it at 1,45,800 and getting 8% profit. So the answer for this particular question is 1,62,000. Now let's solve this particular question. A lends ₹1,500 to B and a certain sum to C at the same time at 8% per annum simple interest. If after 4 years, A altogether receives ₹1,400 as interest from B and C, then the sum lent to C. So in the question, what has happened? A lends money to B and C, and altogether he receives 1400 as total simple interest. So I can say total simple interest received by A is simple interest given by B plus simple interest given by C. So total simple interest already they have mentioned, which is 1400. Now what is the formula for simple interest? How do we calculate it? PRT divided by 100. So over here principal A lends 1500 to B. So principal of B is 1500. Rate of interest is 8% and the timing for which he has given is 4 years. So simple interest earned by B will be 1500 into 8 into 4 divided by 100. Now simple interest for C will be, now they have not given a principal for C, that we need to calculate. I will consider it as P only. rate of interest is same 8, timing is 4 divided by 100. So now just you need to calculate this, what will happen? 1400 is equal to, I will take denominator as common 100. So this is going to be 15 into 8 into 4, which is 16 into 8, you can say 480 and two zeros, 48,000. Over here, this will be 32p. Okay. Now, next thing, what we will do? 1400 into 100 is equal to 48,000 plus 32p. Now, this is going to be 140,000 minus 48,000 means that is going to be 92,000 is equal to 32p. So, p is going to be 92,000 divided by 32. So, if I divide it by 2, this will be 16, this will be 46,000. Again, if I divide it by 2, it will be 8, it will be 23,000. If I divide it by 2 again, this will be 4, this will be 11,500. So further, if you divide it, 11,500 divided by 2 means 5, then 7, and then 5, and 0. And then if you divide it again by 2, 5750 divided by 2, that is going to be 2875. So answer for this question is going to be 2875. Calculation can be done by other methods also, no problem with that. Ultimately, you need to understand method how we have solved this question. So the sum lent to C is rupees 2875. Now let's check this particular question. There is 60% increase in an amount in 6 years at simple interest. What will be the compound interest of rupees 12,000 after 3 years at the same rate of interest? So now we need to understand the question involves both the concept. Initially it is simple interest and then we need to use that rate of interest to calculate compound interest. So what data they have given? There is 60% increase in an amount in 6 years. So what I will do, I will consider initial principal as suppose 100 rupees. If there is a 60% increase, what is going to be the amount? So after 6 years, the amount is going to be 160 rupees, 60% means. You can consider X also and then you can calculate, no problem with that. To make it simple, I have considered as 100 rupees. So initially, I need to calculate rate of interest. So formula for simple interest is PRT divided by 100. So let me tell you, whenever principal is 100 and amount suppose we are considering 160, simple interest is nothing but the extra money which that person has earned. So the extra money over here is 60 rupees, not 160. Because interest is the difference between principal and amount. Principal in this case I have considered as 100. Rate of interest I want to calculate and the time taken for that amount is 6 years divided by 100. So 100 and 100 will get cancelled. R is going to be 10%. Now, this particular rate of interest I am going to use for the second scenario. Like what will be the compound interest on rupees 12,000. So now you can check they have given us principal as 12,000. So what is the formula for amount whenever we are calculating compound interest? It is amount is equal to P into 1 plus rate of interest divided by N divided by 100 bracket raised to NT. Now in this question we are calculating it on annual basis, so value of N is 1. So amount is equal to principal they have provided 12,000, 1 plus rate of interest I calculated it as 10% divided by 100, value of N is 1, and we need to calculate it for 3 years, so raised to 3. So now just calculate this, 10 by 100 means 1 by 10, so this is going to be 12,000 into 1 plus 1 by 10, this is going to be 11 by 10 cube, so 11 by 10 3 times. So just if we calculate this, 0, 0 and 0 will get cancelled. 12 into 11 is 132 and 11 into 11 is 121. So if you calculate this particular value, you will get 15972. But this is amount. We need to calculate interest. What is the formula to calculate compound interest? Compound interest is nothing but difference between amount and principal. Amount is 15972. Principal they have provided as 12,000. So difference between that is your compound interest. So 3972. So answer for this question is 3972. Now let's check this question based on permutation combination. How many 3-digit numbers can be formed from the digits 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 9 which are divisible by 5 and none of the digits is repeated? Okay. So if we want to calculate 3-digit number 1, 2, 3 and it should be divisible by 5. So that means on unit digit place, I can have only 5 or 0. But they have not provided me option of 0. So I'm only having option 1, which is 5. So I can say the number of ways this number can end is only 1, because only 5 can come at the last place. Now, how many other numbers I'm having? 2, 3, 6, 7 and 9. Since they have mentioned digits cannot get repeated, I cannot use 5 again because I have already used 5 over here. So at first place, any digit out of the 5 options can come. So I can write 5. And at the second place, any digit out of the 4 options can come because I have already used 1. So this will be 4. So if you calculate this, answer is going to be 20. So the question is very easy. Since it was divisible by 5, I can end that particular number by only one way, by using 5. And for other first two digits, 5 options for the first place, 4 options for the last second place. So the answer is 20. Now let's check this question. The traffic lights at 3 different road crossings change after every 24, 36 and 72 seconds respectively. If they all change simultaneously at 8:20 minutes or 8 hours 20 minutes you can say, then they will again change simultaneously at. So they have changed simultaneously at 8:20 hours. And they keep on changing. There are 3 traffic different road crossings you can say. They keep on changing after 24, 36 and 72 seconds. So this question is nothing but based on LCM concept. If each and every road is taking like 24, another road is 36 seconds and next road is taking 72 seconds, when they will meet again, they will definitely take more time than this. So for these type of questions, you need to calculate LCM. So LCM of 24, 36, 72, I can divide it by 6. So this will be 24 by 6, 6, 4. This will be 36 by 6. This will be 6 and this will be 12. Next thing, I can divide it by 2. So this will become 2, 3 and 6. And then again, I can divide it by 2. So this will become 1, 3 and 3. And then again, I can divide by 3. So this is the way we can calculate LCM. So LCM in this case, you can calculate 6 into 2, 12. 12 into 2, 24, 24 into 3, 72 seconds. So all the road crossings will take 72 seconds to again change simultaneously. 72 seconds means 1 minute, 12 seconds. They have changed at 8 hours, 20 minutes. So again, they will take 1 minute, 12 seconds extra. So I can say the answer is going to be 8:21, 12. So you can check from the option, answer is 8:21:12. Now let's check this particular question. 200 gram of 25% sulfuric acid solution was added to 300 gram of 40% sulfuric acid solution. Find the concentration of the acid in the mixture. So what they have mentioned, initially it was 200 gram of solution. Out of that, 25% was sulfuric acid. So I can say 25% means 25 by 100 into 200. So this is going to be 50 grams. So initially sulfuric acid was present 50 gram. And it was added to 300 gram of solution in which 40% part is with sulfuric acid. So I can calculate it like 40 divided by 100 into 300. So if you calculate this 1, 3, this will be 120 gram. So can you tell me total sulfuric acid participation? It is going to be 50 gram plus 120 gram. So I can say total sulfuric acid is 50 plus 120 is 170 gram. And what question they have asked? Find the concentration of the acid in the mixture. So I want to calculate concentration of acid in the mixture, which they have asked in percentage. So total concentration, or you can say sulfuric acid, is 170 grams. Total solution is going to be, initially it was 200 and then it was added to 300. So I can say 500. Into 100, since they have asked percentage. So 100 into 1, 100 into 5, 175, 5, it is 34%. So answer for this question is going to be 34%. Now let's check this question. From a group of 6 men, 5 women, 6 persons are to be selected to form a committee. If the committee has at least 2 men and 4 women, in how many ways can it be done? So total they have mentioned 6 men are there and 5 women, and the condition which they have given, 6 persons should be selected and at least 2 men and 4 women should be there. So you can check, there is not going to be different kind of conditions because we need to select 6 persons. And they have already provided us condition that at least 2 men and 4 women should be there. So there can be only one condition that we need to select 2 men from 6. So we can write it like 6C2. And 4 women from 5 women, I can write it like 5C4. So only one condition is 2 men, 4 women, total 6 persons are to be selected, 6C2 into 5C4. So how can we calculate it? 6 into 5 divided by 2 into 1. And 5C4 is nothing but 5C1, because in permutation combination, NCR is nothing but NC n minus R. So I can write it 5C1, which is 5. So if you calculate this, 2 into 3, 3 into 5 is, 3 into 5 is 15, 15 into 5 is 75. So in 75 ways, it can be done.
Let's check this question. A man purchases 2 pens for Rs. 740. He sells one at 12% profit and other at 8% loss. Then he neither gains nor loses. Find the cost price of each pen. So what they have mentioned, together total cost price of 2 pens is 740. So I can say cost price of first pen plus cost price of second pen is 740. He sells one at 12% profit and other at 8% loss. So you can say total profit earned is equal to total loss which he has received, because there is no gain or loss, you can say, in that particular transaction. Find the cost price of each pen. So let me consider cost price of first. So let me consider cost price of first pen as X, cost price of second pen as Y. So I can say X plus Y is equal to 740. Now what they have mentioned, since there is no profit and loss in the whole transaction, so I can say the profit he is going to earn will be 12% of X, and the loss which he is going to have will be 8% of Y, right? So since profit and loss is same, because he is not gaining anything or he is not losing anything, so I can say 12% of X is equal to 8% of Y. So if I calculate this, 12 by 100 into X is equal to 8 by 100 into Y. So 100 and 100 will get cancelled. I can say X upon Y will be 8 by 12, which is X upon Y will be 2 upon 3. So the relation between cost price of first pen and cost price of second pen is 2 by 3. So now you can calculate it like X is equal to 2Y by 3. You can put this value in the first equation. So what will happen? X plus Y is 740. So I can write it like 2Y by 3 plus Y is equal to 740. So 2Y plus 3Y, that will be 5Y, is equal to 740 into 3. So Y is going to be 740 into 3 divided by 5. So 5 into 1, 5 into, that will be 14. So 4 will remain, 40 means 8. So Y is going to be 148 into 3. So if you calculate it, it is going to be 444. So now value of second pen is 444. As you can check in the option, there is only one value representing, or only one option representing 444. So you can directly click on it. But still, if you want to confirm it, X plus Y is 740. So X plus 444 is equal to 740. X is going to be 296. So cost price of first pen is 296, cost price of second pen is 444. Let's check this question. Two trains starting at the same time from two stations 200 km apart and going in opposite direction cross each other at a distance of 110 km from one of the stations. What is the ratio of their speeds? So you can check, there are two stations. Suppose let me consider as A and B, and the distance between them is 200 km. Both are going in the opposite direction. They are going in the opposite direction, and when they cross each other at a distance of 110 km from one of the station. So you can check, suppose if I consider A is covering 110 km at that point, B will cover 90 km because total distance you can say is 200 km. So directly we can find out their ratio, because in the same time, since the time is same, A is covering 110 km, B is covering 90 km. So the ratio between their speed is going to be 11 by 9. So very easy question, timing is same and distance already they have provided. So answer is 11 by 9. Now let's check this particular question based on calendar concept. If 10th May 1997 was Monday, what was the day on October 10, 2001? Now the questions based on calendar can be solved by like week by week you will go, or year by year you will go, or you can use a concept of odd days. Right now I won't be able to clear odd day concept because usually it takes half an hour to clear from very basic, so I will directly use that concept over here. So in this question, what they have mentioned, 10 May 1997, so I will just write it over here, was Monday. And we are going to find it out for 2001 years. So on 10th May 1998, I need to add one more odd day, okay, because it is ordinary year, so that will be Tuesday. Next, 10th May 1999, again it is ordinary year, so I need to add one more day, which is Wednesday. Again on 10th May 2007, on 10th May 2000, since it is leap year, I need to add two odd days. So two odd days means I need to go further by 2 days, which will be Friday. And then 10th May 2001 will be Saturday. And now I need to consider the months or the duration which they have given. So just check, in the May month, total 21 days are remaining. Since May month is of 31 days, 21 days are remaining. 21 days means zero odd days. Next thing, after May, I will have June month, which is 30 days. 30 days means total 2 odd days. Then July, as we know, it is 31 days. I will have 3 odd days. Then August, which will be again 31 days. I will have 3 days again. And then September with 30 days, I will have 2 more extra odd days. And then October, I need to consider up to 10, which will be 3 odd days. So now just calculate the total number of odd days. Total number of odd days, as you can check, 2 plus 3, 5, 5 plus 3, 8, 8 plus 2, 10, 10 plus 3, 13. So 13 odd days means how many days? 13 odd days is nothing but 6 extra day after completing a week. Odd day is nothing but the number of days which are remaining after completing a week. So on 10th May, it was Saturday. So 6 more days after that means on 10th October, I am going to have Friday. So answer for this question is going to be Friday. So what we did, we just calculated the calculated number of odd days and we got answer as Friday.
Thank you everyone for watching this video. If you like this video, please click on the like button and do press on the bell icon to get notifications. I have also added a link of our Telegram group to get campus updates quickly. Just make sure you are joining our Telegram group, and all the very best for your Wipro NLTH exam. Thank you.